Welcome back everyone to yet another video on lithic studies by Speaking Archaeologically. Today we will talk about the measurements of lithic artifacts. The measurement of stone tools helps us in typologically arranging them and to study the role of hand morphology on the stone tool production. The size of the stone tool and the flakes helps us to look at the pressure applied to remove them. To begin with the measurements, we require a sliding caliper. A sliding caliper is a normal scale with a sliding holder attached to it, which helps us to measure any object. The first step is to find the zero error. So you can see that on this particular scale, when we completely close our scale, we don't get zero as our reading, but it shows us a reading of 2 millimeters. Hence, the scale has a zero error of 2 millimeters, and every measurement taken with the scale will be 2 millimeters more than the actual value. To begin our measurement, we will have to choose a reference point. The reference point is usually taken as the midpoint of the platform. So let us measure the platform. It comes around 6.8 centimeters. Hence, our midpoint or the reference point will be taken at 3.4 centimeters, which is somewhere here. Now I'll mark it with a pencil or a chalk. Now that we have our reference point, we will measure our length. Our length will be taken as a line perpendicular to the surface of the platform from the midpoint. This comes out to be 6.3 centimeters. So, now to measure the breadth of the stone tool, you can either take the widest portion parallel to the surface of the platform, or you can take an average of the values taken at 1/4, half and 1/8 parts of the length of the stone tool. The thickness of the stone tool is measured by keeping the scale perpendicular to the edge of the stone tool, and the maximum value that the tool shows will be taken as the thickness of the stone tool. Let us now answer the question of why do we need the measurements. With the increase in studies in the field of experimental archaeology, it is very important to understand the process of knapping. The measurements help us to understand the force applied to the stone tool and the flakes removed while knapping. Along with this, the position of the point of percussion and the angle of the strike or the strike angle can help us to calculate the force or the pressure applied to the stone tool. Not only this, the removal of the flake can also tell us about the type of material that was used as the hammer. For example, larger flakes are usually removed by hard hammer direct percussion technique, whereas secondary flaking and retouching is usually done using a soft hammer, which is either a bone, wood or an antler. Hence, when we apply these variables into the models developed by experimental archaeology, we can better understand the cognitive abilities and behavioral characteristics of the stone tool manufacturers.